made a design the way he refined it over the years, but you know, when you really look at it though, it is a basic simple concept. You know, your hook's in the front, the legs kick. That frog, every time you pull it through the water, it kicks like a real frog. It casts a pretty good ways. You know, if anybody is familiar with his custom series, those custom series are great, but I'll be honest with you, and I don't want to seem like I'm saying that I like the clone better, because I do really love my custom frogs, but because of the weight and the thickness of the clone legs, it actually casts a little further. And when it casts a little further in pressured waters and in places where I don't want to get too close to the fish before I spook them, that's a big deal, you know, being able to get it a little further back in there and get to those fish before you potentially alert them to your presence is huge. And this frog just comes through the thickest stuff around. It'll just come right through it. And then when you stop it, those legs open up and it just looks like a frog that went into a kind of a relaxed posture. These little grooves down the side of banks in these old pastures are just phenomenal places for frogs, because there's a little bit of a trench there and they dig in and hang out on those little edges, and they can lay up in the grass and just wait for minnows or crayfish or frogs to come meandering along the surface and just blast them. Just flat out blast them. You know, and if you don't have a place like this where you're from, you know, this is one of those places that we just happen upon, and it takes a lot of work to get back here. But your local pond or lake, if it's got a creek on it that's got wood in the back, you don't necessarily have to have this surface vegetation to get a good frog bite. Anywhere that there's a good bank, you can throw it up on the bank and crawl it off. And that's another really, really, really effective way to fish the frog, is around wood near the bank. Oh. See that? Hooked the foot. That's what kept me from hooking that fish. Otherwise, this thing is about a bat and 100,000 on hooking the fish. He just happened to have knocked the foot into its mouth, which means he hit that frog so hard that he folded it in half. I'll take that over some of the other designs I've seen any day. And the thing I like the most about the Ken frog is that, you know, the clone is, it adapts itself so well to the throwback. I mean, there's not a lot of lures you can throw back multiple times and just keep getting blow-ups. And I've had bass blow up on this frog 5 or 6 times in a row, where I've either jerked it out of there prematurely or they've wrapped it up around vegetation and I didn't get a good hook penetration. So even if you miss one, you can just go right back in there and get another hook up, and it's deadly. You know, even a superior hook design has a hard time penetrating if you jerk it out of the bass's mouth before they have a chance to swallow it. So, you know, you know, I'm not any different than anybody else. I've had my plenty of moments where I jerked the frog out of the mouth before they had a chance to eat it. So, you know, just get used to holding that rod out in front of you, kind of straight up, fishing the frog on a light line so it gives it a little bit of slack. And then when they blow up on it, you want to simultaneously drop and reel and then set the hook. That way it gives them that extra second to get a hold to it. Maybe one of the hardest things in fishing to master, because, you know, it's just real hard to resist that urge when they blast that frog to not just snatch it. But once you get it down, it is absolutely one of the most fun and effective ways to fish, for especially for your bigger fish.